Commissioner Kenneth Hayne's report is now in the hands of the government. By Monday afternoon, we'll know its content. It's less than a year since the first hearings of the Royal Commission, and the shocks kept coming.
Charging premiums for life insurance to someone who's dead. That's the position, isn't it?
Yes, that's the way the system is treating it today.
Governance expert Danny Davis has interviewed the chairs of seven of the ASX 10, Australia's largest companies.
They understand that they are really struggling to stay on top of it and they feel exposed. You know, what are the things that keep you up at night? Where do I start?
For Mr. Davis, the bigger question is, how will large and complex organisations evolve to meet the challenges of a higher level of scrutiny?
The culture of the organisation is to stick with it and be defensive. And that just doesn't work in a world of continual change, higher risk, volatility.
The Royal Commission's hearings put the blowtorch onto the CEOs and chairs of Australia's big banks and found them wanting. Non-executive director of Wesfarmers and a fellow of the Australian Institute of Company Directors, Diane Smith-Gander, says Australia's corporate culture needs to change. The Royal Commission's questioning floats potential changes to governance, everything from stricter requirements for auditors to more stringent minute-taking of board meetings.
When I watched some of the Royal Commission, I was struck by the high drama of it. And I thought, oh dear, I hope they don't expect me to start behaving like that in the boardroom. Because I thought some of those very tough questions were really great TV, but I don't think they would add up to great governance. We need to be tough, but we need to be fair.
Ms. Smith-Gander concedes the Royal Commission exposed huge issues in governance at the top of some of our biggest institutions. The final report will be a wake-up call for any corporate culture that hasn't been paying attention.
It's very hard to generalise, but Australian companies are known for good corporate governance, and our economy has performed particularly well on the global stage for a very long time.
Whatever the recommendations of the Royal Commission, Australian Securities and Investments Commission Chair, James Shipton, has vowed to take more cases of misconduct to court. Julie Garland McClellan sits on boards and acts as a coach and mentor for directors. She's urging Australian directors to focus more on getting answers and action than just asking questions to cover their exposures.
You're not there to torture management. You're there to get to the heart of the issue and make the right decisions. And management aren't going to fix anything whilst they're reporting to the board in the boardroom.
Commissioner Hayne's report will rock the Big Four banks, AMP and financial services. It may recommend extensive criminal charges, as well as changes to long-standing practices that have been lucrative for banks but detrimental for customers. Also potentially coming, big changes to corporate culture and the duties and expectations of the directors at the top.
The job of the director is to ask those difficult questions and to really make sure that they set the right cultural tone at the top.
We'll know on Monday just how much the rules are set to change.